Today we will do some questions from exercise 3.3. Now we are going to do exercise 3.3, question number 3. So here A transpose is given. A transpose is 3, 4, minus 1, 2, 0, 1. And B, another matrix given. We need to verify A plus B all transpose is equal to A transpose plus B transpose. A transpose is given. So here we need to find A. So A equal to transpose of A transpose. A equal to transpose of A transpose. So when we find transpose of A transpose, we will get A. So transpose of A transpose. In when we find the transpose, the first column will be the first row. When we interchange rows and the columns, we get a transpose of the matrix. So first column will be the first row, second column will be the second row. So first column 3 minus 1 0, 3 minus 1 0, 4 2 1, 4 2 1, 4 2 1. So that is A. A is equal to transpose of A transpose. And B already given. So we can find A plus B first, because in LHS, LHS is A plus B all transpose. So we can find A plus B first. A plus B. A is this one, B. So A plus B. Corresponding elements. We can find the sum of the corresponding elements. 3 plus minus 1. That is 3 plus minus 1. That is 2. Minus 1 plus 2. That is 1. 0 plus 1. That is 1. 4 plus 1. 5. 2 plus 2. 4. 1 plus 3. 4. So that is A plus B. When we find the sum of A and B, we will find the sum of the corresponding elements. 3 plus minus 1, that is 2. Minus 1 plus 2, that is 1. 0 plus 1, that is 1. 4 plus 1, 5. 2 plus 2, 4. 1 plus 3, 4. So that is A plus B. Now we can find LHS. LHS is equal to A plus B all transpose. Transpose of A plus B. So transpose of A plus B. First column will be the first row. 2, 5. 2, 5. 1, 4. 1, 4. 1, 4. 1, 4. So that is A plus B all transpose. Then RHS. RHS is A transpose plus B transpose. So A transpose already given. 3, 4. A transpose is given. Minus 1, 2, 0, 1. A transpose plus B transpose. So we need to find a transpose of B. First column will be the first row. Minus 1, 1. Minus 1, 1. 2, 2. Here 2, 2. 1, 3. 1, 3. Now we can find the sum. 3 plus minus 1, that is 2. Corresponding elements. We will find the sum of the corresponding elements. 4 plus 1, 5. Minus 1 plus 2, that is 1. 2 plus 2, 4. 0 plus 1, 1. 1 plus 3, 4. Now we can compare LHS and RHS. LHS 2, 5. Here 2, 5. 1, 4. 1, 4. 1, 4. Again 1, 4. So we can write LHS equal to RHS. Therefore, A plus B all transpose is equal to A transpose plus B transpose. A plus B all transpose is equal to A transpose plus B transpose. Similarly, we can do the second part of that question. Now we can do question number 6 from the same exercise. Question number 6. Here A is given. A is equal to cos alpha sin alpha minus sin alpha cos alpha. Verify that A transpose into A equal to identity matrix. A transpose into A equal to identity matrix. First we can find A transpose. A transpose. interchanging rows and columns. First row column will be the first row. Cos alpha minus sin alpha. Second column will be the second row. Sin alpha, cos alpha. A transpose. So here A transpose into A. A transpose is this one into A. Cos alpha, sin alpha, minus sin alpha, cos alpha. That is equal to. We can find the product of that two matrices. First row into first column. First row into first column. Cos alpha into cos alpha. That is cos square alpha. First row into first column. Cos alpha into cos alpha. Cos square alpha. Plus minus sin alpha into minus sin alpha. Minus into minus plus. Plus sin alpha into sin alpha. Sin square alpha. Then first row into second column. Cos alpha into sin alpha. That is cos alpha sin alpha. Minus sin alpha into cos alpha. Minus sin alpha into cos alpha. Then second row into second column. Sin alpha into cos alpha. Sin alpha into cos alpha. Plus cos alpha into minus sin alpha. Minus cos alpha sin alpha. Then second row into second column. Sin alpha into sin alpha. Sin square alpha. Plus cos alpha into cos alpha. Plus cos square alpha. Then sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Then cos alpha sin alpha minus cos alpha sin alpha. Cos alpha sin alpha minus cos alpha sin alpha. It will be cancelled 0. Sin alpha cos alpha minus sin alpha cos alpha. Same terms but opposite sign. So again it will be cancelled 0. Sin square alpha plus cos square alpha 1. So this is an identity matrix. So we can say that therefore A transpose into A is equal to identity matrix. A transpose into A equal to identity matrix. Now we will do exercise 3.1, question number 5. Exercise 3.1, question number 5. Construct a 3x4 matrix. Construct a 3x4 matrix whose elements are given by. We have to construct a 3x4 matrix. First part we are going to do Aij. Elements are given by 1 by 2 modulus minus 3 I plus J. 1 by 2 modulus minus 3 I plus J. We need to construct a 3 by 4 matrix. Construct a 3 by 4 matrix. So when we construct a 3 by 4 matrix, we have 3 rows and 4 columns. Three rows and 4 columns. That means 3x4 matrix. 3x4 matrix. General form of 3x4 matrix is general form. General form of 3x4 matrix is A11, A12, A13, A14. Because A11, A12, A13, A14. 4 columns are there. And 3 rows. A21, A22, A23, A24. Then A31, A32, A33, A34. So this is the general form of a 3x4 matrix. So here 3 rows and 4 columns. Now we have to find each and every elements. A11. Aij equal to 1 by 2 into minus 3i plus j. So here 1 by 2 into modulus minus 3 a I j equal to minus 3 into I plus j. So here minus 3 into first number. In the place of I, here we have 1, minus 3 into 1 plus j, that is 1 modulus sign. So a11 will be minus 3 plus 1, minus 3 plus 1, that is minus 2 modulus sign, plus 2, 2 and 2 cancel na, so it will be 1 1. A11 is equal to 1. And similarly A12 is equal to 1 by 2 modulus minus 3 into I plus j, minus 3 into 1 plus 2. And here when we simplify, minus 3 plus 2, that is minus 1, modulus of minus 1 is 1, so 1 into 1 by 2, that is 1 by 2. A13, 1 by 2 modulus minus 3 into 1 plus 3, that is minus 3 plus 3, 0, 0 into 1 by 2, 0. A14, 1 by 2 into minus 3 into 1 plus 4, modulus sign. Minus 3 plus 4, that is 1, minus 3 plus 4, that is 1, 1 into 1 by 2, that is 1 by 2. Then A21, 1 by 2 into modulus minus 3 into 2 plus 1. Then minus 3 into 2, that is minus 6, minus 6 plus 1, that is minus 5, modulus of minus 5 is plus 5, 5 into 1 by 2, that is 5 by 2. Then A22, 1 by 2 into modulus of minus 3 into 2 plus 2, that is minus 6 plus 2, minus 6 plus 2, that is minus 4, minus 4 into 1 by 2, that is minus 2. Plus 2, because minus 4 modulus sign will be plus 4, 4 into 1 by 2, plus 2. A21, A22, A23, 1 by 2 into modulus minus 3 into 2 plus 3, minus 6 plus 3, minus 6 plus 3 equal to minus 3, modulus sign will be plus 3, 3 into 1 by 2, that is 3 by 2. A23, then A24, 1 by 2 into modulus minus 3 into 2 plus 4, that is minus 6 plus 4, that is minus 2, modulus sign, that is plus 2, 2 into 1 by 2, that is 1. Now we can find A24, A31, 1 by 2 into modulus minus 3 into 3 plus 1, that is equal to minus 3 into 3, minus 9, minus 9 plus 1, minus 8, minus 8, that is modulus of minus 8 is plus 8, plus 8 into 1 by 2, 8 into 1 by 2, that is 4. A31, A32, that is 1 by 2 into modulus minus 3 into 3 plus 2, minus 9 plus 2, minus 9 plus 2, that is minus 7, that is a plus 7, 7 into 1 by 2, that is 7 by 2. A33, 1 by 2 into modulus minus 3 into 3 plus 3, that is minus 9 plus 3, minus 9 plus 3, that is a minus 6, modulus of minus 6, that is plus 6, plus 6 into 1 by 2, that is 3. Then A34, 1 by 2 modulus minus 3 into 3 plus 4, minus 9 plus 4, that is minus 9 plus 4 is minus 5, modulus sign is plus 5, plus 5 into 1 by 2, that is 5 by 2. Now we can write the matrix. Therefore the matrix is, we will write that elements in the same order: A11, A12, A13, A14, that is 1, 1 by 2, 0, 1 by 2 will be the first row. 1, 1 by 2, 0, 1 by 2. 1, 1 by 2, 0, 1 by 2. Then A21, A22, A23, A24, that will be the second row. So 5 by 2, then 2, then 3 by 2, then 1. Then the third row, A31, A32, A33, A34. That is the third row. A31, A32, A33, A34. So that is 4, 7 by 2, 3, 5 by 2. So we got the matrix. We formed a 3 by 4 matrix by using the given condition 1 by 2 into modulus of minus 3i plus j. So here I and j we replaced. So we got a 3 by 4 matrix. And here in this question, you need to check the calculation properly. If I didn't make any mistake in calculation, this will be the answer. Okay. Then we will do exercise 3.1, question number 7 we can do. Seventh question. Find the values of A, B, C and D from the equation. A minus B. Question number 7. A minus B. 2A plus C. 2A minus B. 3C plus D. Equal to minus 1, 5, 0, 13. From this equation, we need to find the values of A, B, C and D. So here, these two matrices are equal. If two matrices are equal, then the corresponding elements are equal. So the corresponding elements, A minus B equal to minus 1. Then, A minus B equal to minus 1. Then 2A minus B is equal to 0. 2A minus B equal to 0. Then we can take it as equation 1, A minus B equal to minus 1, 2A minus B is equal to 0, that is equation number 1, and this is equation number 2. And we have two more equations, 2A plus C equal to 5, 2A plus C equal to 5, and 3C plus D equal to 13, 3C plus D equal to 13. So from first two equations we can find the values of A and B, and when we replace that value we will find the value of A, and when we replace that A here we will get the value of C, and when you replace C here we will get the value of D. So here by elimination method we can find the value of A from second equation. Sorry, from these two equations. Equation 2 minus equation 1 implies 2A minus A. 2A minus A, that is A. Minus B minus minus B, that is minus B plus B cancel. Then 0 minus minus 1, that is equal to 1. Once again, equation 2 minus equation 1. 2A minus A, that is A. Minus B minus minus B, that is minus B plus B cancel. 0 minus minus 1, that is 0 plus 1, that is A is equal to 1. Then equation 1 implies, replace the value of A in first equation. A is 1, 1 minus B, replace A by 1, 1 minus B equal to minus 1. So you take minus 1 from right to left and B minus B from left to right. So minus 1 becomes plus 1, 1 plus 1 equal to minus B becomes plus B when we take from left to right. Therefore B equal to 2. Now we got the value of A equal to 1, B equal to 2. Then this is equation number 3 and this one 4. Equation 3 implies, replace the value of A in equation 3, 2 into, we will replace A by 1, 2 into 1 plus C equal to 5. Therefore C is equal to 5 minus 2 into 1, that is 2, 5 minus 2, that is 3. C is equal to 3. Now we got the value of C, 3. Then replace C in fourth equation. Equation number 4. 4 implies 3 into, replace C by 3. 3 into 3 plus D equal to 13. Therefore D equal to 13 minus 3 into 3, 9. So 13 minus 9 that is equal to 4. So now we got the values of A equal to 1, B equal to 2, C equal to 3 and D equal to 4. So these are the values of A, B, C and D. Question number 3. If a matrix has 18 elements, third question. If a matrix has 18 elements, what are the possible order it can have? Number of elements. Number of elements is equal to 18. We have 18 elements. What are the possible orders it can have? So when we have 18 elements, if you write all the 18 elements in a single row, we will get a possible orders. When we write all the 18 elements in a single row, we will get a 1 by 18 matrix. 18 elements we are writing in a single row, 18 elements we wrote. Then we have only one row and 18 columns will be there. So the order of that matrix will be 1 by 18. Then the second order, 18, because 1 into 18, total 18 elements. Then we can write it as 1 by 18, or if you write that 18 elements in a column, in a single column, 1 by 1, 18 elements. Then we will get a 18 rows and one column. So 18 by 1 is another possibility. 18 by 1. Then next possibility, 2 into 9. 2 rows and 9 columns. Total number of elements will be 2 into 9, 18. Then 9 into 2, another possibility. Then 3 by 6. 3 into 6, 18. Total elements are 3 rows and 6 columns. 3 by 6 and 6 by 3. Then 4 by any number not possible, 5 by not possible, 6 by 6 by 3 already written. So these are the possible orders of the matrix having 18 elements. 1 by 18 or 18 by 1, 2 by 9, 3 by 2, 3 by 6, 6 by 3. So these are the possible orders. Now we will do page number 82, exercise 3.2, question number 19. Exercise 3.2, question number 19. The question: A trust fund has rupees 30,000 that must be invested in two different types of bonds. Total amount 30,000 and divided into two different types of bonds. The first bond pays 5% interest per year, and the second bond pays 7% interest per year. Using matrix multiplication, determine how to divide 30,000 among the two types of bonds. If the trust fund must obtain an annual total interest of rupees 1800, first part 1800, and the second part rupees 2000. So here we have total amount 30,000. We have 30,000 rupees and we need to divide it into two bonds. and from the first bond we get 5% interest per year, and from the second bond we get 7% interest per year. If the total interest is 1800, then how can we divide the 30,000 into two different types of bonds? Total amount 30,000, and we have to divide it into two different bonds. So we can take it as, let the bonds be rupees X, and we have 30,000 rupees, and the first bond is rupees X, so the second bond will be 30,000 minus X, rupees X and rupees 30,000 minus X. Second bond will be rupees 30,000 minus X. And here interest from the first bond is 5%, and interest from the second bond is 7%. So we can write in matrix form, we have the total interest is 1800. Total, first part we are doing, total interest is equal to 1800. Total interest is 1800. So here the bond amount we can write in a row matrix. First bond, then second bond 30,000 minus X, and the interest, rate of interest we can write in column matrix. And here the percentage of interest from the first bond 5%, 5% means 5/100, and rate of interest of the second bond, that is 7/100, and here the total interest will be 1800. Now we can multiply this one. Number of columns of the first matrix and number of rows of the second matrix is the same, so we can multiply first row into first column, that is X into 5/100, X into 5/100 plus 30,000 minus X, 30,000 minus X into 7/100 is equal to 1800. Then we can simplify, 5x/100 plus, open the bracket, 0 and 2 zeros cancel, 2100 minus 7x/100 equal to 1800. Now we will simplify, 5x/100 minus 7x/100, 5x/100 minus 7x/100, that is minus 2x/100 equal to 2100. We can take from left to right, that is 1800 minus 2100. So 1800 minus 2100, that is equal to 300. So minus 2x/100 is equal to minus 300. Minus 3 and minus 3 cancel. Then cross multiply, 2x is equal to 300 into 100, 30,000. Therefore, x is equal to 30,000 upon 2, that is 15,000. Now we got the value of x, 15,000. The total amount is 30,000. The first bond is rupees 50,000, 15,000. Therefore, the second bond will be 30,000 minus 15,000. That is also 15,000. Therefore, first bond is equal to rupees. First bond is rupees X. That is 15,000. And the second bond. Second bond is equal to 30,000 minus 15,000, that is also 15,000. So now we got both the bonds. So once again, here total amount is given 30,000. We need to divide it into two bonds. The interest, rate of interest of the first bond is 5%, and the rate of interest of the second bond is 7%. the total interest in first case, that is 1800, we need to divide that amount. So let the bonds be x and rupees 30,000 minus x. First bond x and second bond 30,000 minus x. Then rate of interest 5% and 7%. So total interest in first case 1800. So total interest, the bond amount we can write in row matrix and the rate of interest in column matrix. X 30,000 minus x column matrix, this one. Then we will find the product x into 5 by 100 plus 30,000 minus x into 7 upon 100 is equal to 1800. That is 5x upon 100. Then simplify, 100 and 100 cancel, 300 into 7, 2100 minus 7x upon 100 is equal to 1800. Then 5x upon 100 minus 7x upon 100, that is minus 2x upon 100 equal to 1800 minus 2100. That is 1800 minus 2100, that is minus 300. So minus 2x, minus and minus cancelled. So 2x is equal to 300 into 100, that is 30,000. Therefore, x is equal to 15,000. So the first bond is rupees 15,000 and the second bond is 30,000 minus 15,000, that is also same amount, 15,000. Similarly, we can do second part, interest here 1800 will be replaced by 2000, then we will get the values. Then we will do one more question. Exercise 3.3, question number 5. For the matrices A and B, verify that AB all transpose. A is given 1, minus 4, 3, and B minus 1, 2, 1. Then we need to verify AB all transpose is equal to B transpose into A transpose. AB all transpose is B transpose into A transpose. Now we are going to do first part. First part is this is 3 rows, 3 by 1. This is 3 by 1 matrix, 3 rows and 1 column. And this is 1 by 3 matrix. So here number of columns of the first matrix and number of rows of the second matrix same. So we can find the product of AB. So we will get a 3 by 3 matrix. Then AB all transpose we will find. And then LHS and RHS we will verify. First we can find AB. AB will be a 3 by 3 matrix. AB will be a 3 by 3 matrix. So when we find AB, first row into first column. 1 into minus 1. That is minus 1. First row into second column. 1 into 2. That is 2. First row into third column, 1 into 1, that is 1. Second row into first column, minus 4 into minus 1, plus 4. Second row into second column, minus 4 into minus 2, minus 8. Second row into third column, minus 4 into 1, that is minus 4. Third row into first column, 3 into minus 1, minus 3. Third row into second column, 3 into 2, 6. Third row into third column, 3 into 1, 3. So that is AB. Now we can find AB all transpose. Means a transpose of AB. So here first column will be the first row. Minus 1, 4, minus 3. Second row column will be the second row. 2, minus 8, 6. 1, minus 4, 3. 1, minus 4, 3. So that is AB all transpose, that is LHS. Now we have to find a B transpose into A transpose. B transpose into A transpose. So B transpose. So B is given. So B transpose will be, first row will be the first column. This is row matrix. So its transpose will be a column matrix. So minus 1, 2, 1. B transpose. Into A transpose. This is column matrix. Its transpose will be row matrix. 1, minus 4, 3. Then B transpose into A transpose. And here, this is 3 rows, 3 by 1 matrix. And this is 1 by 3 matrix. So the answer will be 3 by 3 matrix. Same way we will find the product. First row into first column. Minus 1 into 1. 1. Sorry, minus 1 into 1, minus 1. First row into second column. Minus 1 into minus 4, plus 4. First row into third column. Minus 1 into 3, that is minus 3. Second row into first column. 2 into 1, that is 2. Second row into second column. 2 into minus 4, minus 8. Second row into third column. 2 into 3, 6. Third row into first column. 1 into 1, 1. Third row into second column. 1 into minus 4, minus 4. Third row into third column, 1 into 3, 3. Now we can compare both the matrices. Minus 1, 4, minus 3, minus 1, 4, minus 3, 2, minus 8, 6, 2, minus 8, 6, 1, minus 4, 3, 1, minus 4, 3. So we can write AB all transpose is B transpose into A transpose. Therefore, AB all transpose is equal to B transpose into A transpose. Okay.